Hi, this is Rich. Welcome to my blog. Hey, I'd like to talk to you today about how to release feeling negative. Now, the idea here, before we even get started, this has to do with a technique that you can use on yourself, by yourself, to release your negative feeling states, emotions, negative thinking, limiting beliefs, things like this. And the reason it's a good idea has to do with, in order to get better, improve your condition, what's to know is that really what needs to be dealt with is not so much the world around you, but your inner stuff, your inner issues, conflicts, meaning your beliefs, fears, worries, concerns, needs, desires, wants, hopes, wishes, all this stuff. So different teachers tell us that, well, yeah, you want to, you know, let go of the baggage, you know, you let go of that stuff. And we go, yeah, good idea, but how the fuck do you do that? What, how? So I'm going to show you a technique that's relatively simple. But let me tell you the story, why I put this technique together myself, and it works pretty well. But what happened was, like, over 40 years ago, I had shit going on, and I didn't feel good about myself. I didn't feel like I could interact with people very well, and I was kind of shy and couldn't talk and communicate very well. And I wanted to get out of body. So I looked around and I searched around for things, and the next thing I know, I'm finding out about past life regression and how the mind works. And so I learned all this stuff about how to use past life regression to release limiting beliefs, painful emotion, and other issues connected with getting out of body, so that I could get out of body more. And I was also hopeful that I could learn how to release things that would help me be a better communicator, express myself better. So I got involved in that, and duh, very expensive. Costs a lot of fucking money to learn how to do that shit. And took a lot of time to learn the techniques. And so I did that for a few years. And then I kind of got done with that, and it was time to do something else. And while doing something else, I was still seeing a lot of my own issues, limiting beliefs and negativity and emotion, negative stuff. It was like, there's a lot of work yet to do. I go, wow, man. Well, I don't want to go back to that old stuff. It's too fucking hard. You need a facilitator to do the past life regression stuff. And it's just a lot of damn work. And I go, man, there's got to be an easier way. And so I took what I learned about how stuff gets released. And it basically has to do with getting in touch with the issue or the stuff. And I was doing it through mainly past life regression work. But then the idea is to get the person doing the clearing or the communicating to, they're getting in touch with their stuff, and then they got to communicate it. They got to express it. They got to feel it. They got to remember it, focus in on it, and start talking it out. And the more they can talk it out, the more they're able to bring up their beliefs for inspection. They're more able to just re-feel the feeling state newly, and yet this time be able to express the feelings or get the feelings out. They weren't necessarily able to get out the first time the traumatic incident occurred, you know, whether it was 5-10 years ago or whether it was 2 or 3 lifetimes ago, didn't matter. So I go, okay, look, I know what it takes. I know basically we got to talk it out. And I was getting pretty good at that. I was to help people talk their shit out and contact their emotional stuff and get it said and get a release. So I go, okay, yeah, I get it. And I realized that we hang on to our emotional stuff, our worries, concerns, fears, all that stuff. And we hang on to our limiting beliefs, because it seems like the right way to feel, or it seems like the right thing to believe. It just fits. It's right. You know, it's just, you know, if somebody tailgates you, and if you get real angry about that, on a deep level, and maybe even on the surface, it's the right way to feel for you. It's like, yeah, yeah, what am I supposed to do? Wave and be smiley? You know, I get that I am told to shake it off. I get that it's not a good idea to get really freaking angry on the road. I get that, but I can't help it. I just, this is my emotional reaction. So we realize, we know that we have certain emotional responses in certain kinds of situations. Some people can ignore us. We're talking, trying to talk, and we're being ignored. And it doesn't bother us. For sometimes we're ignored, and it really pisses us off. So it's like our emotional response is the right emotional response for ourselves. So when you do this, you dig in, you look at the deeper reasons and the deeper aspects of your issue, your negative feeling or negative emotion, or your negative belief, you look deeper at it, and you start looking at it newly, and you see either the sense and the rightness in it or the wrongness in it. You say, "Go, that's not right," and you will start seeing how you drew wrong conclusions in your past that took you to the conclusion and the decision that this is the right way to feel in these kind of circumstances. This is the right thing to believe. And so, with all that said, I go, okay, yeah, yeah, I know what I can do. I can help a person determine what their issues are, and then they can talk it out. All I need to do is come up with the right questions, and I call these the universal release questions. All you got to do is come up with the right questions, ask the person, and then be a good listener, and that person being willing to talk about their negativity, their issue, their worry, their concern, their fear, their need, their want, whatever. They're willing to talk about it, to look inward and find their own answers about their issue from within. And then talk it out, express it. I go, yeah, 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 I can do this. I can make this work. So, you know, I had friends I could do it with, and either I'm asking the questions and they're talking to me about their issues, or they're asking me these same questions and I talk about my issues. The questions are set up in such a way that there's a blank in each question, and you can literally plug in your issue. And then you have all the questions you need, and you get more than you need. And the trick then becomes simply to answer the questions, look inward, answer the questions, and express your thoughts and feelings. And this will eventually help you release the negativity. Okay? So that's the theory behind it. And so I came up with these questions over 20 years ago. This was before text readers really made it on the scene. This is actually 1992. I was really into doing this. And so as text readers came on the scene and they got better and better, I realized that the text reader could ask me the questions instead of another person. And if I record the session, I'm recording my answers on the recorder. So I feel like there's some place I'm downloading, not just talking to the wall or talking to thin air. I feel like it's being downloaded, so it allows for that feeling state or that need to express it and get it out of you and somewhere else. Normally, if you have a person to talk to, they are like a grounding terminal, like a hot terminal discharges electrical energy from the positive to the negative or from the negative to the positive, the ground, okay? So the other individual, the listener, becomes the ground. But you can also use a recorder as the ground. And if you get really good at it, you don't even need a recorder. You can just talk it out. So anyway, I'm going to give you a demonstration of how this works right now. And if you're interested in learning how to do the course, you can come to richwest.net and you can learn how to do this stuff and start releasing your negativity, limiting beliefs, negative belief systems, and negative emotional stuff. And you'll know it's releasing because after you start talking about it for a while, and maybe just 10 minutes, 20, 30 minutes, 40 minutes, an hour, whatever it takes, you just keep talking it out, keep answering the questions till you start getting releases. And you'll know you're getting releases because you will start laughing or chuckling. you will burst into a good feeling emotional expression of the thing. You'll feel the rightness in expressing your feelings, and ultimately by the end of the process you feel a release. Literally the emotion releases, or you stop believing that limiting belief, literally, and you feel better, and you have realizations about the emotion or about the belief or whatever it is. So that's how it works. So now I'm going to give you a little demonstration here. I'm using the text reader. It's the free version of Natural Reader 14. And the voice speaker is David, or David Desktop or something. Anyway, and I'll record right here on this recorder. And I'm only going to answer a few of these questions. The script that you will get when you buy the course, you'll learn how to do all this stuff, and you will get the questions. And oh, there might be over 50 questions of the final script. But you can basically ask the questions in any sequence, so you can change your script around and tweak it and all that. But you'll learn the basic principles of how to release your negativity. Okay, so I'm going to do something a little... The feeling is I'm feeling a bit off today, you see. So I need to talk about it. And because something happened recently in my life, and it's very sensitive, and it's not really something I want to just share with the world. So as I share this with you, I might be a little vague in what I'm talking about, but for myself, I know exactly what I'm talking about. So the process will still work in that way. So I may or may not do this process to a full release, because it is just a demonstration. Sometimes a session can take an hour, and I'm, you know, and normally listening to a session isn't all that exciting, but as a demo, especially if you're still with me and you think you might want to learn how to do the universal release method, here it goes like this. So this is the session. Here we go.
What does feeling a bit off mean exactly?
What does feeling a bit off mean exactly? It means, I don't feel comfortable in my own skin. I don't feel, I can't quite get angry. I'm not quite afraid. I'm worried and concerned, but it's kind of under the surface. And it's really bothering me, but I'm not allowing myself to fully engage in the frustrating issue because I don't see any solution to the thing that's bothering me. So what I'm feeling is a bit off about it all.
Fine. What might be some of the reasons for feeling a bit off?
Well, a friend of mine is in trouble, and she's going through some really painful emotional stuff, and I can't be there for her right now. And I want to help her. I don't know what to do or how to do it. And, you know, I've gotten really, really angry at those that are messing with her. And the whole situation is really complex and complicated. And the best I can do is feel a bit off. I should be outraged, or I should be crushed, but it's really hard.
Fine. Is feeling a bit off new to you?
Well, this kind of feeling is kind of new, yeah.
Fine. What does feeling a bit off suggest?
It suggests that... I'm suppressing, holding this stuff in. I should be outraged. I should be angry or something. Or in tears about it all.
Fine. Can you get in touch with feeling a bit off now?
Yeah, right now, yeah. Yeah, I can feel a bit off.
Fine. Does letting go of feeling a bit off appeal to you?
Yeah, it does. I'd like to let go of this feeling, but I don't know what I would end up with if I let this go. I get a feeling that this feeling is actually a solution to something, a feeling that's more difficult to experience. But we'll get into that in a little bit.
Fine. Are there any advantages to feeling a bit off?
Well, feeling a bit off, I already laughed. That was a little chuckle laugh there. That was, I spotted one truth of this. Feeling a bit off is a lot better than how I could feel if I wasn't feeling a bit off.
Fine. Are there any disadvantages to feeling a bit off?
Well, yeah, just feeling this way sucks.
Fine. Is feeling a bit off supposed to keep you out of uncomfortable situations?
Well, it's an uncomfortable situation in itself, but at the same time, if I were to allow myself to fall into the next emotion that is like queuing up, ready to go under the surface, suppressed, then that would create extremely uncomfortable situations, I'm pretty sure. Okay. Now, as a coach here, showing you how this works, each question gets you to dig in and look a little deeper at some other aspect of what you're feeling and why you are feeling that way. And what's it going to take to let it go? Okay, so that's some of the principles behind this. And so for each question, you just talk it up as much as you want. The more you can talk it out, the better. And sometimes you'll find a question that you don't like, so just skip it, ignore it, and go to the next one. So you get your release. And again, I've been doing this a long time, so I can get a release oftentimes in 10, 15 minutes, 20, 30 minutes. But even still, I get sessions where it takes me over an hour to talk it out. And for new people on this, it could take a 2-hour session. But the thing is, it works. So you'll be able to do these sessions. Okay, that's all.
Fine. What does feeling a bit off keep you from having to confront?
Oh, let's see. How angry I am. Who I'm angry at and why I'm angry at them.
Fine. Is feeling a bit off supposed to help you get by somehow?
Well, it's supposed to help me not get into this other heavier fucking emotion. It's really too much to confront right now.
Fine. What might have to happen before you could feel comfortable about letting go of feeling a bit off? Fine.
Whoa. Don't say fine yet, bitch. You gotta pay attention to your text reader, because it wants to... You gotta pause after each question so you can answer it. I didn't pause fast enough. Like... What would have to happen before I could feel comfortable about letting go of feeling a bit off? Oh, and by the way, as the text reader is reading it, it's also highlighting each question, so I have it here to refer to as needed. What would have to happen before I could let it go? I think I'd have to let go of being afraid for my friend that I love so much, care so much for.
Fine. How does feeling a bit off work?
Well, something hits you that's very emotionally alarming and disturbing on a deep fucking level, and there's not a goddamn fucking thing you can do about it. That's the thing. I don't feel like there's anything I can do about it. I just gotta wait it out and see what happens. A bit off. To put off, more like it. So I'm feeling a little bit of release. There's more.
Fine. As regards feeling a bit off, do you have a plan?
Not fucking really. Deal with best I can, release what I can. Wait and see how it goes. In another week or two, I'll know better what's going on. God damn it. Oh, man. It's just unsolvable goddamn problems, what it is. Feel a bit off. Yeah, feel a bit off, all right. Feel like, fuck you, world.
Fine. Is there anything that you like about feeling a bit off?
Not fucking really.
Fine. In what kinds of circumstances are you most likely to find yourself involved with feeling a bit off?
Well, this kind of bit off. Like a bit off more than I could chew. But when I'm involved with some kind of unsolvable problem, and I have to just fucking wait, helpless, on the sideline. Ah, fucked up. Used to be I'd go get fucking drunk, but have some fucking beer or some shit, or pig out on ice cream or, you know, chocolate, junk food of some sort. Always makes for a great fucking mood changer for a little bit. But I'm trying to be on a healthy kick, and that's another thing. I'm trying to get back on a real healthy diet, so I'm eating more fruit and raw veggies and stuff. My diet's changing, and that alone will cause a person to feel all kinds of weird emotional shit. And then you'll pull in a weird emotional shit. You feel it, and then you manifest it. So that's kind of going on, I guess, too. I feel a little more clear on this stuff. It's releasing a little.
Fine. What does feeling a bit off allow you to do in most cases?
I don't know. Starting to release. It gives me it allows me to feel a certain way that is better than feeling completely helpless or frustrated or angry, fearful, frustrated and afraid. It allows me to feel something better than that, and helplessness. Fuck. See how this works? This, you start digging in and you see that, oh, I get it. This feeling state I feel is a solution, not a fucking problem. Everything we're holding on to is in some way, some weird ass fucking way, a considered or perceived solution to something deeper. And these questions just help us dig in and see what our issue is a solution to. And then once we decide, we see what the deeper issue is or what this is really about, we can choose to let go of our fucking solution. Because it's not like a problem that you can't let go of. It's a solution that you could easily let go of and swap it out for another solution. Or no solution at all, and just confront the deeper shit. Kind of works like that.
Fine. What is feeling a bit off supposed to do for you?
What's it supposed to do for me? Keep me from having to confront that helpless, afraid, frustrated, fucked up, fucking angry, hostile feeling. Because a part of me is afraid, but I also want to get angry and at the wrong people for the wrong things, but it seems like the right people and the right things. It builds up. There's so many aggravations, frustrations that I see everybody dealing with these days. God, it's just disgusting. The evil on this fucking planet is unconfrontable. It's like, how bad is it? You do not want to fucking know. God. Every time I feel like I got a grip on how fucking bad it is on this fucking planet, I learn something new about, no, that's nothing. Here's what's going on, really. Been going on for years. Oh, man. What I'm referring to now is like shit like smart dust, chemtrail stuff, and chemicals in our air and water, vaccines their children have to get. Oh man, this place is fucking brutal. There's not a goddamn thing we can do about it. There is, but this is just me talking out my ass. Yeah, fuck, ain't nothing we fucking do about it, motherfucker. Kind of like that shit. You just got to get off the negative bullshit. Your negative feelings, your pessimistic attitude, This process gives you an opportunity to get that shit out of here. The fuck out of here. There's a little release, too.
Fine. How does feeling a bit off affect you?
It makes me feel like shit. Makes me feel a bit off.
Fine. In what kind of world could you more easily let go of feeling a bit off?
Well, if it was just a bit off, like, you know, everybody's wearing you go to the beach, new beach, somewhere in the fucking south of France or someplace, and you go there wearing your swim trunks, you know, baggy fuckers, kind of like almost like, well, just comfortable swim trunks. You look around, everybody else wearing the fucking Speedos. They're running around fucking naked. And you go, you might feel a bit off. You're the only one wearing fucking clothes. Or the other way around. You go to the beach, buck naked, and you go, oh, oops. You're the first one on the beach, fall asleep. It's a nice balmy day, no problem. You got a little umbrella, you're good. Nude beach, good, nice. You wake up, 10 o'clock in the morning, people everywhere. This is not a nude fucking beach. You're on the wrong beach, dude. Feeling a bit off. That's fucked up. Okay, so I'm feeling a little bit of a release here. I can go on and on here and get more and more of this release, but did you see how it kind of starts sneaking up on me a little bit by little bit, and you start getting the laughs and the chuckles and stuff? But go a little further, I'll get a more better realizations about all this, and I'll feel even better. But this is a fucking demo, not the goddamn entire session, okay? Oh, I'm sorry, I'm being bad here. I'm all being bitchy, and so I better be nice here. Okay, back on teacher coach mode here. I could end it off, but then I got a little bitchy and I started talking up like that. So I'm still feeling a bit off. Yeah, that's true. So I would just continue with the session. I just ask the next question, and it's always best. You always want to end off on a good release and laugh and a realization, and you will feel the thing released completely, or at least to a degree. And you can always pick it up again, do it some more later. But in the moment, in the now, you want to not feel the feeling state that you've been releasing, that you start out feeling in the now. Or you start the session believing some negative shit in the now, and then by the time you get to these laughs and chuckles and realizations, you literally do not believe the thing you believed when you started the session. So it's a way to release your negative feelings and negative beliefs. Thus, this is how to release your negativity. Okay? Let me do a couple more questions here.
Fine. Does feeling a bit off help make things better?
Not fucking really. Well, it depends on what I'm going to feel instead.
Fine. As regards feeling a bit off, is there anything you might do?
Well, yeah, I might take a break. Go get something to eat. Lift my blood sugar up a little. That should fucking help. Yeah. So that's one thing we often do, is when we feel a bit off, we go eat something. Well, I'm trying to be healthy, so I don't plan on eating anything junk food, like sweet, sugary, full of carbos. And that alone will make you feel a bit off when you're trying to be healthy and you're faced with your cravings.
Fine. As regards feeling a bit off, is there anything you are not willing to do?
Yeah, eat a pint of fucking ice cream. Oh, that would fix it for a little while. Yeah, and which brings me to the realization, this is probably part, big major part of the reason I'm feeling off in the first place, is because I did eat a pint of fucking ice cream a few days ago. And I have a serious sugar reaction. I cannot eat sugar. It makes me feel a bit off. Fuck. It just body throws my body chemistry out of shape. Okay. So I've released it, at least for now, for a little bit. So this is a good place for me to take a break. And so that's what we're doing as far as this demonstration goes. Okay?
Fine.
Okay, done deal. No more text reader. So this is just a demonstration of how you can release your negative feeling states and your negative beliefs and stuff. I teach you how to do this, the entire course, and you get the release questions and everything. You can go over to richwest.net, find out more about it. But yeah, it does help. And I put this whole thing together long ago because it was too expensive to find people to talk to talk it out. So this will help you talk your stuff out. And you can do it on your own, in your own time, in your own place, and you can get great results. Okay? All right. Hey, thanks for listening and watching. I'll talk to you later, okay? All right. Bye-bye.